Hello, welcome back to Captain Bones. As you can see, we are back on the Green Island and let's get that steering wheel. Hey, hey. No biting. So what's so hard about finding the steering wheel? I don't know. I guess it's really underwater. Kind reminder, there are sharks in the water. Apparently the sharks will eat you if you try to enter the water. Who the fuck? Okay, let's make a few more spears. I think we can kill the shark with a spear. I never tried it, but that's how it should work in theory. In practice, I don't know. We'll see. Do I have a fire right here? Not really. Actually, I do have a fire because I'm very well prepared. No, actually, I think you should build fires on all parts of the island, depending on where you want to go. I built a fire over here because there are some shipwrecks over there, and I thought there would be something for me to get later on, but hey, I guess later on is right now. Oh, my fire stick broke. Well, guess we have a lot of fire sticks, so spear goes over there. So you can probably take the raft with you as well, but I think taking the raft will be a problem. Oh, we became a skeleton. Well, that's good because then we don't need oxygen to breathe, but at the same time we have a lot lower HP. I feel like I'm Solid Snake. Well, if we're here, we can also steal the gold in the chest. Yeah, I don't think there is anything left for us to do over here, so let's just... Oh, that's a ship. Oh, that's so nice. Oh, I cannot wait to start pillage and plunder. Well, the curse, as you can see, has its uses, so that's why you probably should, you know, invest a lot of skill points into getting the stuff you need. Can you walk on the ocean floor? No, not really. I guess you should be able to walk on the ocean floor as the skeleton. Well, that was a lot easier than I thought. That's because I explored this area already and I knew where I would find the steering wheel on the shipwreck. Well, I guess there's nothing left for us to do but to go back. Well, I guess you are a very, very busy pirate, but still I think this is a lot of busy work that could have been avoided. What do I need for my stick? Ah, I have a lot of stuff, okay. I guess we can also fish a little bit since we haven't done it in a while. Hey, seagulls, wake up. Captain Bone has a very interesting life. Easy now, easy. Okay, I just want to catch two fishes. I don't think you can catch different types of fishes or you can find treasure or stuff like that while fishing. Why is this a quest item? I don't remember having a quest to fish. Yeah. It's a hunger item. Okay, Yeah, I can see a lot of potential for this game, but right now I think the game is only limited by the, I don't know, by the long crafting timers and by the huge amount of busy work you have to do. Oh yeah, that also scares me every time. So see, you have to enter the animation and then you have to wait until the timer is ready and you cannot do anything else while you're doing this. So I think that's the only problem, the crafting timers that will lock you into the animation, see? You should also have the option to cook three fishes at the same time so you don't waste time entering and exit the animations over again. Why did I cook the fish? Well, simple, I need healing and fish is good healing. Also drains your first bar, your water bar, I don't know. Okay, where was that quest item? Oh, I have to bring 10 fishes to him. Okay, let's do that as well. I guess it can be relaxing as well. Okay, I see a lot of potential for the game, but I think it just takes a very long time until you reach the core elements of the game, which is commanding your own ship. Also, this quest is weird. You should have to catch only 5 fishes. 10 fishes is a little too much in my opinion. Let's see how much time we need to catch 10 fishes. So, we need about 10 seconds per fish, right? Or more than 10 seconds. But I guess it mostly depends on the fish. Now, we need 20 seconds per fish, so that means 200 seconds, so that means for 3 minutes you'll basically be fishing. Oh no, it's 25 seconds for each fish because of the weird animations. Like I said, you should be able to do actions in a row so you don't do the animations over again. I mean, I'm sure we'll need the money at some point. We have almost 500 gold. Most of it is because I visited that little island. I also found a shipwreck over there. I guess I was very lucky to be Captain Bones in the water so I could find the steering wheel a lot faster. I think they do mention you can breathe underwater indefinitely as the Bones. I guess that's an interesting mechanic, but it's a little bit randomized since you cannot really go and get the steering wheel without being in Bones form in curse mode. Because I tried to go underwater with my human form and guess what, you almost died. I almost died. And once the shark just came and ate me. Yes, yes, inspect every fish because it's something you have never seen. Also, the fishing rod has durability. Well, I guess we can be happy they don't make us search for worms or stuff. I was also waiting for it to become daytime. Achievement unlock. Beginner fisher. Beginner level fish hunter, okay. It would be funny if some of the seagulls started stealing your fish when you catch them. That would be a fun mechanic, even though it can get annoying. So yes, I'm pretty sure the ships can be plundered because they have an interactable item on their deck, which probably only contains gold for now, but you kind of get the idea. Maybe we'll try to board one on our little raft, but I don't think we can do it since it's very high, so we probably have to... I don't know, we probably have to jump on it? Also, there are no ships stopping over here, which is weird. Wait, wait, where is that one going? It will crash into the... Okay. They are changing course. Surprisingly, the game doesn't have as many bugs as I thought, because they kind of made the game very, very solid. At least for now, early access, you know. Okay, last fish. Okay, from now on I'll never fish ever again, because I think we'll stick to coconuts. The fishing is just takes too long. It's almost like fishing in New World. Yeah, I wish New World was a lot better as well. I mean, they updated it and they introduced new things, but it's too late. The game is so boring and yeah, I'll not ever play that again. I think I'd rather play indie games like this that have potential rather than play AAA games who have no... Come on, you can do it. Okay, this is going to be weird. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Let's not do anything stupid, so... We have to save the game before we leave, otherwise I think we might do something stupid and, you know, forget about everything and then have to catch 10 fishes all over again. Which would be a disaster. So yeah, I'd rather play indie games that have some potential rather than play the clones, the generic games that are basically the AAA industry right now. I don't know, it's weird because... A game like this is more interesting because it's different than the usual stuff. There was supposed to be a pirate game coming out pretty soon, but I forgot its name. I was playing a lot of Sea Dogs 3 a few years ago, well, 10 years ago. And I kind of miss playing the pirate game. There were so many pirate games 10 years ago, 15 years ago, because that's what games are about. Having fun and adventure. And what is more fun and more adventurous than the pirate? Okay, I like this map a lot. As you can see, it's super easy to navigate it. You can basically use it... Okay. I already like the sailing in this game more than in Valheim. Since it doesn't take you 10 hours to go from one place to the other. Well, at least for now. Also, we have an island over here as well, to the Lost City. I think it will contain some treasures at least. Also have these two islands over here as well to explore. But I think it will be part of the tutorial, so for now, not bother with them. Also, your little raft loses durability as you sail the water. Which is a little bit... too much in my opinion, but I understand why the developers did that. But I don't know, it just creates more busy work for you. You're a pirate, you're not a carpenter. I guess you can be both, right? Okay, sailing is fun, but I would like to reach my destination. You can even see the ship on the horizon. So, I don't know, maybe the next episode will explore these two islands, actually these three islands. It depends on what I find. I mean, I could also go to the back of the island to disembark, but... I think I'll do it right here, since I have the campfire over here. Ah, the winds are very good to us today. Also, don't know what to do with the coconuts. Yeah, that sounds brutal. I'm not sure how to do the coconuts, the empty ones, so I just left them on the beach. I think the game could benefit a lot from RPG systems like experience systems. So, for example, if you have 10 levels in fire starting, you start the fire instantly almost. But I guess that could be abused, so I don't know. There might be some gold left on the island, but... Oh, no, no, no. I don't think I want to try and find every last piece of gold. And that looks like it has something on it. So for now, let's just build our ship. I forgot to talk to the food merchant. Okay, let's go back and talk to the food merchant. I'm mostly doing the quest because I'm curious if he will give me another quest. Hey, do you know you have snakes on your island? You should clean up your island first. There is something shiny up there. Okay, we'll take a look, why not? So that's the weapon merchant. I think the food merchant will be here. Oh, poor shark. Oh, I feel bad about him. I guess we can buy another fishing rod. It's not so expensive. You can... Can you buy 10 fish from him and then give him back for the quest? Probably. So this makes it a lot easier because you can even get the coconuts, and the coconuts are pretty cheap. Huh. Oh, a bank. Well, it's not open, or it was open, then it's closed now. Shovel? Oh, I don't really. Ship mast part, ship rope, shovel. Should I buy a shovel? I don't know what it does, but I guess we need a shovel for our adventures. Okay, I guess it can be used to search for treasure. I like that a lot. So what's the big secret around here? Oh, thank you. I was getting a little thirsty from all of the treasure hunting we just did. You know, this guy is making me thirsty as well, drinking that coconut with such pleasure. I think this is what we saw glowing in the night. I don't think there will be other stuff, but again, I still believe there are some secrets left for me here to find. I'm just not sure if it's worth investing time right now. Yeah, the jumping is a little funky. It's a little weird. See, you do only a small jump if you jump like that. Okay, let's try it one more time. I'm trying to jump on the little ledge so to see if I can grab it. Oh yeah, you can grab it. Come on, go up. Pull yourself up. Ezio. The man with the hammer is doing a lot of parkour. Okay, let's see if we can grab this one. Yeah, I can see this game having so much potential just because of the mechanics that are already in the game integrated. Okay. Okay, probably we can... okay, wait, what? Wait a minute, are you saying I can just go over here? And jump like that, really? Oh, I'm amazed. You're really like in Assassin's Creed sometimes, really? In a game like this? Okay, and that's another two treasures we found on the island. I guess we searched the other ones. Okay, let's do our quest. You know what? You deserve some treats here. Hey, what is this? Was I supposed to turn into Captain Bones, but we didn't turn for whatever reason? I guess we are supposed to be Captain Bones. No, why did you turn? I'm a peaceful skeleton, you have to believe me, I'm just cursed, not a necromancer. Well, we still need to eat and drink. Well, this is problematic, sorry about this. I was not expecting to be Mr. Bones. So again, we'll have to save our game because I don't want to lose all of this progress I just made. I guess I kind of like the save system, I kind of don't love it. I guess it depends on how I do my tasks. I don't know, it's a bit annoying because look at this, you have a skill tree. And what are the first things you will pick when playing the game? You'll pick this one, learning to see, because I don't want to have vision distortion that makes me sick. I mean, if you have the vision distorting and you're sailing on the water, you might get a little seasick, or I don't know, you'll just hate the game in general. And then reducing time to half, because as you can see, I cannot do my quest because I'm a skeleton. And then full transformation, because I want to change at will. And then the last one is Captain of Bones. I guess the developers are thinking when you're in skeleton form, you should probably go and see what's on the beaches over there. Well, I guess that's another thing we have to do. Yeah, I think it's going to be another 2 minutes or something like that before I can change back. Okay, let's go on the little raft and see what's on the other island. Also, always carry enough food with you to repair the little thingy. Easy now, easy. And we're moving. But I guess if you stay near the island, the sharks will not come to eat you. Okay, be prepared. You'll save yourself a jump scare. Be prepared. So I think we heal. I mean, also want really. I really want numbers instead of those stupid circle menus. You are a very bad shark. Okay, let's repair it now before I forget. I'm also running out of fiber, so as you can see, just by playing the game, you lose so much, I mean, so many resources just by repairing stuff. I think we'll need our little ship or little raft, because it will send us in the neighboring islands. Anyway, we'll go to the neighboring islands in the next episode. I don't know, I might be forced to make another fire over here and cut down all of the trees in the area. We'll just have to see. Stop? Okay, it stopped. Build. I guess this is the easy part. Oh, you even need the hammer, okay. Oh man, we only have the steering wheel for the ship. I think it will be a very long time before we can use this as a real ship. Ouch. Well, we saw where we have to buy those items. Luckily for me, I know where to buy them, so I guess I can just go and buy them. I'm not sure if I have enough gold or not. But I guess, yeah, I guess we'll stick to the plan. Next episode, we'll visit these two islands, and then I'll have to build a ship. Okay, that's easy. Easy and fun. See you next time. Wait. Before I forget, let's build a fire. Oh, this will be so loud. Well, I guess it's good for the atmosphere. So I want to make it very, very clear that you have to be very, very careful where you save. Hey, it looks like there are many ships around this area. It would be funny if the people could get bitten by the snakes as well. See you next time. Bye.